at our pizzas, we can see one side. Yes, so let's say we have, you get to choose if you get 2/4 of the pizza or you get to have 2/8 of the pizza. Which one are you going to choose?
I want the bigger one.
You want the bigger one, right?
I want the bigger one.
You want the small one?
Yes.
Let's say you're super, super hungry. You haven't eaten in 3 days. Which one are you going to choose?
You're gonna, all of these.
Right?
Like all of it.
So you want the bigger pieces, right?
Yeah.
That's
so
like the alligator.
Exactly. So the alligator wants to eat
two fourths
and not 2/8, right? So a good way to think of it is that when we see the numerator, one is bigger than the other, we're going to think that one has more smaller pieces, right? Right? Okay, so now we're going to look at ones that have the same denominator. So these are a little less tricky. I'm trying to keep them all organized for the next group. After that, they can be all populated. We're going to do it by just looking at these triple pieces. Right. Look at the picture. So, how many pieces are in this fraction all together?
8.
And how many are shaded?
6.
Awesome. Look at this one.
That is 7.
7.
And 4 shaded.
Yeah.
Let's look at it again.
Wait, 8 and 4 shaded, I think.
Right?
That's 5.
Oh, 8 and 5 shaded.
Right. So when we look at these, how are we going to compare them? Which one is going to be greater than the other?
This one is
going to
be... That one.
This one? And how do we know that?
Because this one has 5.
And this one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And this one has how many?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, so we can also look at them, right? When we look at both the fractions next to each other.
Yeah.
You can see that there are more pieces shaded just looking at it, right?
Yes.
Awesome. So we don't have any equivalent, but we can think about being equivalent. How about that? So when we look at this one, how many pieces do we have in our fraction? How many pieces are in the whole?
It looks like 10.
How did you know it looked like 10 before counting every single one? How did you know it looked like 10 before counting all of them?
There's 11.
And that's half of it?
There's 11.
There are 10 pieces.
And the smaller?
Yeah, because this is 5 and that was 5.
That's great. It's a great way to look at it really quickly. How about this one?
8.
And how many are shaded?
5.
Right?
You could do
3 minus 3 plus 5.
So, when we look at these fractions, what's this one equivalent to?
5. I'll be a whole 10.
Oh, 1/2.
1/2, right? Uh-huh. And we could just look at it, right? You did a great way of figuring out how many pieces, and then also knowing that this part is only shaded, we know that's exactly half, right? Now, looking at this one, how many pieces are shaded?
5, 6, 8.
It's how many pieces, and 5 are shaded. So which one's bigger than the other?
That.
And how do we know that?
Because they're bigger.
The pieces are bigger, right? And another way to look at this one is we know this one's half, but how many pieces is half of 8?
4.
And do we have more than 4?
Yes.
Awesome.
But the 5 and the
5. Okay, how about this one? How many pieces are in the whole?
5.
No. 6.
And how many are shaded?
2.
What's our fraction?
2/4.
So what's our fraction?
Two six.
What's this one?
Six. Four six.
Okay, so how do we know which one's bigger than the other? What is greater than?
I would say he would eat this one because this one looks more bigger than that one.
So we still have six pieces. Each of them has six pieces, right?
Yeah.
But which one has more shaded?
That one.
So, right, we'd eat this way. And we know that because there are still six pieces in our hole, but four are shaded, and four is bigger than two, right?
Yes.
Let him eat it. Oh, that's the wrong one. Let him eat that one. There we go.
He doesn't want two pieces.
Yeah. Exactly. What's our fraction?
One third.
Two thirds.
I can't even hear.
You want to know why we know that quickly? Because when you see it's divided up, you can't do
one. Yeah.
It's a big number.
Which one is going to be greater than the other?
That one's going to be greater because I think that one's going to be greater because that has two, and that one has one.
Exactly. So when we're looking at just the fraction, we can look and see if the denominator is the same, we'll look just at the numerator, and whichever number is bigger, we know, right?
And or we could check it with the butterfly.
Yeah. So that's a quick way to look at it, and then if you want to check it, you can do the butterfly multiplication too, right? But if they have the same denominator, we can quickly look at the numerator and tell which one's bigger, right?
Yeah.
But you're right. It's a great way to do it.
Now, can we compare ourselves? So, like, two of us are wearing pink, and two of us are wearing black.
Yeah.
And then we could do
that. Which one is bigger?
Pink.
2 out of 4 versus 2 out of 4.
That'll be equal.
Equal
to. So we're equal to. I have two pairs. I have one pair of pairs of
pairs. And now we're looking at our fractions that have the same numerator. Okay.
My unit fraction.
Sure. But they have the same number on top, but different numbers on the bottom.
Smaller numbers,
like
1/8 and 1/6.
Exactly. So, what is our fraction?
One third.
Yeah, we have three pieces. And how many shaded?
One third,
right? Uh-huh. How about this one?
One out of six.
Meet in the middle. So when we look at these two fractions, how do we know which one's bigger?
We look at the denominator, and this is 7, so it's really smaller. So
bigger.
The alligator mouth is going to go here, because it's going to be
big. Exactly. So we can even... So when we look at it, we can see that there are more, the more is shaded. And you're right. You can also look at the denominator and see which one has more smaller pieces, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
But if two of those are shaded, that would be equal.
Exactly.
Yay. Because 2 equals 1, 2, and 4 equals 2. 4 times 4.
Okay. What is our fraction
piece? This is 3, 4.
And what about this one?
3, 6.
So they both have three pieces. Which one's bigger though?
This one because this I want this at 4 and it's more bigger. So if you have 4 for 4, you'd all have delicious big pieces.
Okay, you're right. Another way we can look at this is what is this fraction equivalent to?
One half. And this is more than one half.
That's great. That's another way we can look at it, right?
Yeah.
Great. You guys rock this. Look a little worried. You guys got this. Okay. What's our fraction?
One half.
So how do we know which one's bigger?
This one.
Because that
was the bigger piece. And because this is half, exactly half, and this is not half because you can't have half of this.
That's great. Round
I want a square piece, not round piece. Can we put the little box?
We will. Just a second. Let's do one more example. How about that? Okay.
Okay. That is six.
Yes, how do you know that?
Well, first of all, you just took the 3 plus 6.
Because I can recognize the
3, and then I have a more 7.
That's great.
Six.
Okay, so they both have 6 pieces, but how do we know which one's bigger?
This one, because this all has
all of them.
And one hole is more than close to it.
Right, exactly. Okay. So now, Merry Christmas. So what we're gonna be doing is that we're working on a worksheet.
Is that like worksheet?
We have pencils. Well, we have pencils, so.
You wrote it.
I did write it.
You have good handwriting.
Thank you. Well, I printed it and then I wrote in the numbers just because it was easier. So, before we start doing this, we're going to represent them with these pieces, okay?
I like pencils.
Right, exactly.
Can we get a ring on
it? Yes, go ahead. So, is this the right amount of pieces we need?
Yes.
No.
How about this one?
Yes.
Is that the right amount of pieces we need? Okay.
I just made nail polish.
I miss green.
R-A-I-N-E. I just smell nail polish.
She smells nail polish.
I do not have nail polish on.
I don't have nail polish on.
It smells like nail polish.
So we need the pink pieces, right?
Yes. I want these. These are cool.
They are pretty cool. There's lots of little pieces, right?
And I have this.
It's probably hard.
Yeah, it's great when you're trying on school and you get to college.
College.
You know. Not everybody does that.
Well, do you have to go straight or do you spend a couple days at home?
You can spend the summer at home.
Okay.
Okay.
Because she's going to be 17. She was a first grade, but she moved up because she was the smartest person in the grade.
I understand. My birthday is really late in the year, so I'm one of the youngest.
That's why I'm sad all the time. I'm the second youngest in my family.
So, okay, if we're looking at this first fraction, how do we build that? We need to build 3/5.
Yes.
How do we build 3/5?
3/5. I want to take 3 of these. I want to take 1.
What if we shaded them in?
Shade.
That's how we look at it, right? We know these are the 2 that are taken away. We'll just do it like that. Now let's make 4/5 with this one.
4/5.
So how do we know which one is bigger?
That one is bigger because that one has 4 and that one has 3.
Yay.
And this one is...
So how do we represent that?
4 and 4, wait, 5.
Which is bigger?
4 and 5.
Right.
4 and 5. So the alligator mouth is going to eat the 4 out of 5.
Yeah, okay. So next one, our next one.